There's way more to Saturn than its majestic rings. The planet also boasts a collection of 62 exotic moons. Perhaps the most interesting of them all is Enceladus, a bright white ice ball with a liquid water ocean wrapped inside its frozen shell that continuously erupts as a towering water plume through cracks near its south pole. This exotic moon is also the site of NASA's newest discovery, which suggests it may support life. In today's video, we will be taking a closer look at this moon and if it does indeed have the perfect conditions capable of supporting life. Saturn is the sixth planet from the Sun and the second largest planet in our solar system. Adorned with thousands of beautiful ringlets, Saturn is unique among the planets. It is not the only planet to have rings, made of chunks of ice and rock, but none are as spectacular or as complicated as Saturn's. Like fellow gas giant Jupiter, Saturn is a massive ball made mostly of hydrogen and helium. The size of the majestic planet is quite colossal, as it would take around 9 Earth-sized planets placed side by side to span Saturn's diameter, and this doesn't even include its rings. The planet orbits at a distance of around 886 million miles from the Sun, which means it takes about 10.7 hours for it to rotate on its axis once. Saturn is a gas giant planet, and therefore does not have a solid surface like Earth's, but it might have a solid core somewhere in there. Saturn has 53 known moons, with an additional 29 moons awaiting confirmation of their discovery. That is a total of 82 moons. It is also famous for its spectacular ring system, which consists of 7 rings with several gaps and divisions between them. Few missions have visited Saturn. Pioneer 11 and Voyagers 1 and 2 flew by, but Cassini orbited Saturn 294 times from 2004 to 2017. In the night sky, Saturn is easily visible to the unaided eye as a non-twinkling point of light. When viewed through even a small telescope, the planet encircled by its magnificent rings is arguably the most sublime object in the solar system. Saturn's name comes from the Roman god of agriculture, who is equated with the Greek deity Cronus, one of the Titans and the father of Zeus. Viewed from Earth, Saturn has an overall hazy yellow-brown appearance. The surface that is seen through telescopes and in spacecraft images is actually a complex of cloud layers decorated by many small-scale features such as red, brown, and white spots, bands, eddies, and vortices that vary over a fairly short time. Saturn cannot support life as we know it, but some of Saturn's moons have conditions that might support life. Many of the planet's satellites, or moons, formed at the same time as the rest of our solar system more than 4 billion years ago. Saturn's largest moons, in particular, display a record of that long history in the extensive craters that cover their surfaces. But recent modeling suggests some of Saturn's moons may be younger, possibly only 100 million years old or less. One way scientists can tell their ages is by looking at how closely the moons orbit the planet. A gravitational tug of war between planets and their satellites pushes the orbits of the satellites outward into space slowly over very long periods. For example, our moon is drifting away from Earth each year at about the rate that fingernails grow. The recent study suggests that, if Saturn's moons were as old as the solar system, ones that are close to the rings would have drifted much farther away by now. This conclusion conflicts with the apparent age of the moons from their heavily cratered surfaces, but it adds new ideas to the ongoing quest to puzzle out the history of the Saturn system. Scientists believe that Saturn's moons did not form at the same time. This is because there are moonlets still forming today at the outer edge of Saturn's rings. Some of Saturn's moons, including its smallest and innermost major satellite, Mimas, might have formed from the same material that made its iconic rings, which also may be much younger than previously thought. This material could include pieces of comets and asteroids that broke up around Saturn. Or maybe early moons shattered into pieces after colliding or straying too close to Saturn, where they were ripped apart by the tugging of the giant planet's gravity. Another theory is that the planets rearranged a billion years or so after the solar system formed and stirred up the small bodies around them, sending them flinging and colliding all over the place. Potentially, a great recipe for new moons. It also appears that some moons were adopted by Saturn. The pockmarked Phoebe likely came from afar and was captured by Saturn's gravity at some point. Perhaps the most interesting of all of Saturn's moons is Enceladus. few celestial objects in our solar system are as compelling as this icy moon. A handful of worlds are thought to have liquid water oceans beneath their frozen shell, but Enceladus sprays its ocean out into space, where a spacecraft can sample it. From these samples, scientists have determined that Enceladus has most of the chemical ingredients needed for life and likely has hydrothermal vents spewing out hot, mineral-rich water into its ocean. About as white as Arizona, Enceladus also has the whitest, most reflective surface in the solar system. The moon creates a ring of its own as it orbits Saturn. Its spray of icy particles spreads out into the space around its orbit, circling the planet to form Saturn's E-ring. Enceladus is named after a giant in Greek mythology. Pictures from the Voyager spacecraft in the 1980s indicated that although this moon is small, only about 310 miles across, its icy surface is remarkably smooth in some places and bright white all over. Enceladus is the most reflective body in the solar system. For decades, scientists didn't know why. Because Enceladus reflects so much sunlight, the surface temperature is extremely cold, about minus 330 degrees Fahrenheit. But it is not as cold and inactive a place as it appears. Enceladus orbits Saturn at a distance of 148,000 miles between the orbits of two other moons, Mimas and Tethys. Enceladus is tidally locked with Saturn, keeping the same face toward the planet. It completes one orbit every 32.9 hours within the densest part of Saturn's E-ring. Also, like some other moons in the extensive systems of the giant planets, Enceladus is trapped in what's called an orbital resonance, which is when two or more moons line up with their parent planet at regular intervals and interact gravitationally. Parts of Enceladus have craters up to 22 miles in diameter, while other regions have very few craters, indicating major resurfacing events in the geologically recent past. In particular, the south polar region of Enceladus is almost entirely free of impact craters. The area is also littered with house-sized ice boulders and regions carved by tectonic patterns unique to this region of the moon. In 2005, NASA's Cassini spacecraft discovered icy water particles and gas gushing from the moon's surface at approximately 800 miles per hour. The eruptions appear to be continuous, generating an enormous halo of fine ice dust around Enceladus, which supplies material to Saturn's E-ring. Only a small fraction of the material ends up in the ring, however, with most of it falling like snow back to the moon's surface. This helps keep Enceladus bright white. The water jets come from relatively warm fractures in the crust, which scientists informally call the Tiger Stripes. Several gases, including water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, perhaps a little ammonia, and either carbon monoxide or nitrogen gas, make up the gaseous envelope of the plume, along with salts and silica. And the density of organic materials in the plume was about 20 times denser than scientists expected. From gravity measurements based on the Doppler effect and the magnitude of the moon's very slight wobble as it orbits Saturn, scientists determined that the jets were being supplied by a global ocean inside the moon. Scientists think that the moon's ice shell may be as thin as half a mile to 3 miles at the South Pole. The average global thickness of the ice is thought to be about 12 to 16 miles. Since the ocean in Enceladus supplies the jets, and the jets produce Saturn's E-ring, to study material in the E-ring is to study Enceladus's ocean. The E-ring is mostly made of ice droplets, but among them are peculiar nanograins of silica, which can only be generated where liquid water and rock interact at temperatures above about 200 degrees Fahrenheit. This, among other evidence, points to hydrothermal vents deep beneath Enceladus's icy shell, not unlike the hydrothermal vents that dot Earth's ocean floor. With its global ocean, unique chemistry, and internal heat, Enceladus has become a promising lead in our search for worlds where life could exist. The moon has been the center of attention for many prominent astronomers since this astonishing discovery was made. It is only a matter of time until more evidence comes forward, which may definitively prove if Enceladus truly has the conditions required for life to thrive on its surface. What do you think scientists will discover? Do you believe Enceladus has the atmosphere required to sustain life, or will our search for a hospitable planet continue? Please share your thoughts in the comments section below.